Today, let us know the meaning of the poem Ozymandias, written by Percy Bysshe Shelley. Ozymandias by Percy Bysshe Shelley. I met a traveler from an antique land who said, "Two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert, near them on the sand. Half sunk, a shattered visage lies, whose frown and wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command tell that its sculptor well those passions read, which yet survive stamped on these lifeless things, the hand that mocked them, and the heart that fed. And on the pedestal these words appear, 'My name is Ozymandias, King of Kings. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair. Nothing beside remains, round the decay of that colossal wreck, boundless and bare. The lone and level sands stretch far away.'" I met a traveler from an antique land. The speaker recollects his meeting with the traveler from an antique land, who told him a story about the ruins of a statue. He then describes the present condition of the statue. Half sunk, a shattered visage lies, whose frown and wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command. The statue is half sunk in soil. Shattered visage. The face of the statue is damaged. He then goes on to describe the face using the words frown, wrinkled, lip, sneer of cold command. He then says its sculptor well those passions read. Here the traveler tells the speaker that the frown and sneer of cold command on the statue's face indicate that the sculptor understood the emotions or passions of the statue's subject very well, which yet survive stamped on these lifeless things, the hand that mocked them and the heart that fed. The narrator then says that though the sculptor and his subject are both dead, the memory of the emotions survives, for it is stamped on the lifeless statue. And on the pedestal, these words appear, "My name is Ozymandias, King of Kings. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair. Nothing beside remains. My name is Ozymandias, King of Kings. Look on my works, ye mighty, and despair." Ozymandias thought himself so mighty that even others who claimed their works were mighty would pale into insignificance. To contest this claim would be their ruin. The inscription reinforces the idea that this once all-powerful leader thought greatly of himself, declaring himself the King of Kings, whose greatness could never be surpassed by anyone. These words written on the pedestal, the stand that once held the statue, now seem meaningless, the statement of an arrogant dictator. A contrast to this boast is the present condition of the statue. Nothing beside remains round the decay of that colossal wreck, boundless and bare. The lone and level sands stretch far away. Around the decaying ruin of the statue, nothing remains, only the lone and level sands, which stretch out around it. This broken, weathered statue lies in a desert, a desolate place that extends for miles and miles. Not many people pass through the desert, or would want to, in contrast with the past glory. A once great leader is lying in ruins and will be buried in the sand in time. Shelley's Ozymandias is a poem that talks about mortality. This poem is taken from the perspective of a traveler who only saw the remains of the great Ozymandias in depleting statues. This ruler was once fierce and feared, but like all things, his reign and his so-called greatness was forgotten in later years. Overall, this sonnet paints a picture of an egoistical character who thought himself without rival and was cruel to his people. Shelley's poem describes effectively the fact that no leader, king, dictator, or ruler can overcome time. In other words, the greatest kings and rulers like Napoleon, Julius Caesar, and our own great kings like Ashoka, Krishnadevaraya, have a common character, their inability to outlive the empires they created. This poem reminds the reader of the destructive forces of time, history, and nature, which all living things are susceptible to. The poem also depicts that reign, success, power, tenure, money, health, and prosperity are not eternal, as they can only last so long before being swept into the lone and level sands. Much like the great Ozymandias, whose once greatness and tyranny is now a disfigured mess in the desert of his native country. About the poet, Percy Bysshe Shelley, 1792 to 1822, was one of the major English romantic poets. He became an important influence for the subsequent generations of poets, including Robert Browning and W.B. Yeats. Ozymandias is one of his best-known poems. It is a sonnet, a form wherein the poem is comprised of 14 lines. In this poem, Shelley depicts the stillness in the lines. Two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert. Near them, on the sand, half sunk, a shattered visage lies. And quickly shifts to the movement brought in by time, the changes brought about by time. Nothing beside remains, round the decay of that colossal wreck, boundless and bare. Here, time is depicted as a destructive force that causes decay and exhibits mortality. In the poem, the statue is a symbol of pride, ambition, and power. The fact that the statue has been destroyed emphasizes that human power is temporary. Everything has an end. Nothing is permanent. Ozymandias was mortal. Similarly, his power and pride was mortal and vanished with him. The desert and time swallowed his vain pride, and the same fate awaits the powerful of today.